This video is brought to you by Oculus. I have a confession to make. I have never played Resident Evil 4 before. I'm a newer fan of the series, having gotten my start with Resident Evil 7, the remake of 2, and of course, Resident Evil Village earlier this year. With so many people comparing Village to 4, I've been meaning to go back and experience the game that Yahtzee and many others on the Escapist team were constantly speaking in high regard of. Better yet, I was excited at the prospect of playing it in VR for my first playthrough, considering I've enjoyed the first-person perspective of 7 and Village. So when Oculus reached out to provide us with an Oculus Quest 2 and a code for Resident Evil 4 in VR, I jumped at the opportunity to give the game a try. Speaking of the Oculus Quest 2, if you don't know already, it is the latest headset from Oculus that's fully wireless and doesn't require a PC or any extra sensors to use. You'll need Wi-Fi, the Oculus app on your phone, and then you just install games directly on the headset and you're ready to play. Well, yes, this video is sponsored. I was very impressed with the ease of use of loading up the headset for the first time, considering you essentially just turn it on, log into Oculus via Facebook, and you're ready to go with no extra setup required. If you do want to connect it to the PC for a more traditional VR experience, Oculus also provided us with a link cable, which allows you to play your Rift titles and utilize your gaming PC's hardware instead of playing directly from the headset. Playing Resident Evil 4 for the first time, and also in virtual reality, has been a very interesting experience. When we think of VR games, we often think of the latest and greatest tech and being fully immersed in a brand new world, but before playing Resident Evil 4 in VR, I hadn't really thought about experiencing games from the past in such a way. The new perspective makes an old game feel brand new again, even if you've already played it before. Since Resident Evil 4 was fully rebuilt for VR, but retained its original aesthetic and sound design, it feels like you're literally stepping into and living an important moment from video game history.
Where's everyone going? Bingo?
The combination of old-school visuals and sound design, with the updated gameplay mechanics only possible in VR, provided a unique feeling that I hadn't gotten from any previous VR experience before, and it has me really excited at the possibility that other older classics could be recreated in VR as well. As for Resident Evil 4 itself, the game transitions well to the VR format while still retaining a classic feel. One of the main features that really drives us home is the gear menu system where you organize your items, which is oddly very satisfying in VR. And the tension ramps up considerably with combat in the first-person perspective compared to when playing outside of VR, when you're having to frantically switch between weapons and items to stay alive in the game, while being attacked in virtually every direction. Specific moments in VR are far more memorable too, like facing down the regenerator, or if you haven't played the game before, having your audience kindly trick you into shooting a lake a few too many times.
Oh shit!
Yeah, that was fun. Having experienced the latest Resident Evil games in a non-VR setting, playing 4 in VR made what would essentially be a retro game at this point feel like a brand new experience. You're playing the game in a new perspective, directly interacting with the world, and dealing with the visceral new tension of having a chainsaw-wielding maniac right in front of your face. If you haven't experienced Resident Evil 4 before and had the opportunity to play it in VR for your first playthrough, you should definitely give it a try.